the primary industry has got the greatest growth potential perhaps of any of our industries if we use science properly. We've just got to get over the mindset that agriculture is low technology. It's in fact very high technology, although I think we're only a small part up the ladder.
We really need to take advantage of the fact that we have not just really strong primary industries here, but we have absolutely fantastic high-tech innovative researchers.
We don't get stuck in what is traditionally done. We think about how we can, we look at a production system and how we can tweak that to have a more valuable product going out for New Zealand.
For me, the way our science gets used is the really important thing, that it goes to help industry to do things better, to make their industry more sustainable in the long run, both economically but obviously environmentally as well.
We start with things like auto steer on the tractor, and once you've got it on one, you've got to have it on them all. So you turn at the end, hit the button, and it automatically drives to the far end. But that allows us to spatially apply different products and fertiliser in different areas to match exactly what the crop needs. The returns are huge. The opportunities to even the crops up, it just means that we can really drive productivity without actually necessarily using as much fertiliser.
There is much more need to collaborate with those producers overseas and the importers and exporters. And that brings together scientists from, I guess, all over the world, but also from the different disciplines of science.
Certainly within a sort of a Māori space, when thinking about mātauranga Māori, there's all of it has been informed by an evidence base. Just like there's no endpoint to science, you know, it's something that's constantly evolving, and we're developing our understanding and, you know, deepening our knowledge. We can do the same thing both with mātauranga and also the relationship between the two and how we can use them.
Uplift in performance, productivity and profitability is going to come from research and technology, is going to come from innovation.
Innovation is kind of part of our, it's become part of our culture. So everyone that works here knows that what we do is we redefine the future. We try and improve the lives of our customers, you know, so we're constantly trying to change the way farmers use our technology.
There's so much more complexity to the forestry sector. It's not just a person on a chainsaw cutting a tree down. Our field operations are changing so much. We've got robotics coming in, we've got UAVs, we've got laser technologies that we use from the sky. It's a constantly changing world, and it's just so fascinating.
You can be working with, you know, the Callaghan Institutes and the Ridditts and be creating products that are high value and branding those and then carrying them to the world with our New Zealand imagery.
We've got this challenge. We're not local, but we can use technology to make ourselves local. And, you know, that's a huge opportunity for us to reposition where we sit in the supply chain.
There's a lot of areas there that science is used now. And I think that what I would want to see and hope that the young people can see is that this is somewhere they can develop a passion for.